Hello everybody, this is Deepak Khatri, and in today's video we are going to program our MS430 G2553 using Code Composer Studio and a cheap USB to UART bridge. Let's get started. To download Code Composer Studio, you must go to www.ti.com/tool/ccsstudio. Now scroll down to the link where it says download Code Composer Studio. That link will take you to this page where you can find download links for different version of Code Composer Studio. We are going to use Code Composer Studio version 10, which is the most recent version. Now you have to select the installer which best suits your operating system and internet bandwidth. Offline installer will take about 1 GB and the web installer will take about 23 MB for Windows operating system. The web installer will download the remaining files on demand. After extracting all the files, you can start the setup process. At this stage, you are required to choose all the parts you want to work with. I will be choosing MSV430 and some other parts I want to work with. For flashing your MSV430 microcontroller through BSL using CCS and any generic USB to UART converter, you will require this command line tool, link for which you can find in the description box below beside other useful information. To program MSV430-G2553, you will require any 3.3V compatible USB to UART bridge with access to these RS232 lines, TXT, DTR, RTS and RXT. This board here is based on FT232RL chip from FTDI, but you don't require this board as long as you have access to these RS232 lines and your board is 3.3V compatible. I have modified this PL2303 based USB to UART bridge to access DTR and RTS line, and this one works great. The reset of MSV430 is active low, and if you are going to use this MSV430 chip out of this breadboard connection, you will require at least a 10 kilo ohm resistor between your reset pin and VCC. It is nice to complete the reset circuitry with a capacitor between your reset pin and your ground so that your MSV430 will reset on power up. To test the setup we just created with basic Blink program, open up Code Composer Studio, click on New, CCS Project, select MSV430-G2553 as your target, give your project a name, and from basic examples, choose Blink the LED. This program will toggle bit 0 port 1 pin, thus blinking the LED connected to pin 2 of our MSV430. To flash MSV430 through BSL, we require our firmware or payload in TI-TXT format. And to configure Code Composer Studio for generating TI-TXT format firmware, you have to go to Project, Properties, select MSV430 Hex Utility, enable MSV430 Hex Utility. Now go to Output Format Options. Here you have to select TI-TXT format or TI-TXT Hex format. Now apply the changes and close. Now to automatically flash the firmware image onto our MSV430 using this build button, we are going to create a post build step incorporating PSL demo executable file.
This is the command we need to run as our post build step. We need to edit two things here: script location, which is the location where we have put our BSL demo program, and COM port for our USB to UART bridge. To update script location, open up File Explorer, go to the location where you have saved the script, click on the address bar, copy it, and just put it here. For COM port, open up Device Manager, plug your USB to UART bridge, then you will see the COM port like this. Update it here. After everything is done, copy the command, go to Code Composer Studio, Project, Properties, Steps, Post Build Steps, and paste the command here. Now you just have to click on Apply and Close. Now to build the program and flash the firmware onto our MSP430, you just have to click this build button. Here you can see the program has been successfully flashed and it has been successfully verified. The only drawback of our setup here is that you cannot upload the same program again and again, because it will just try to build and see that there is nothing to build, and it will not get to the post build step and it will not upload the program. If you want to upload the program, you need to edit something, then click on build button.
I just flashed a new firmware onto the MSP430. You can see the blinking pattern here. I'll just update and upload the code again here. Now you can see the blinking speed has been reduced. Congratulations if you have completed all the steps and you got your LED blinking.